There is already some great information out there about 3D printer tools for press brakes. However, I haven't seen anyone using these together with a vise. Unsurprisingly, this also works great. The punches and dies take up little space, are cheap to make, and can be printed in whatever size and shape you need, which makes them perfect for hobby use. Being able to fairly accurately bend sheet metal is a great addition to the capabilities of a home shop, and therefore I would like to share some of my experiences with you. Obviously, the first thing you need is a vise. Mine has seen better days, however it should still do the job. A small vise like this one right here can work too, however the size of your parts is going to be somewhat limited, and same goes for the force you can create, which directly translates into the thickness of the material you are able to bend. The dies and punches need to be printed fairly solid. I'm using 5mm with a 0.8mm nozzle, 80% infill and 0.2mm layer height. For shapes like these, PLA or PETG on itself should be strong enough. However, for special shapes like this gooseneck punch, you might want to increase its strength by reinforcing it with steel wire, like I showed in a previous video. Of course, this also depends on the force you apply on the tool. However, you definitely don't want PLA to shatter under heavy load right in front of you. This brings us to the traditional safety instructions. Do this at your own risk and definitely wear safety equipment. The maximum thickness I have tested so far are 3mm in aluminum and 1.4mm in steel. These values are definitely not the final limits, however I right now don't have any thicker material at hand. Even though the length of the dies and punches is limited to the size of the vise jaws, making longer bends is no problem. By just gradually creating the bend while moving the part back and forth, we can not only get a pretty accurate 90 degree angle, but it also looks very uniform. Modeling the dies and punches in Fusion 360 is fairly straightforward. It's basically just one extruded sketch. Make one side to fit right onto your vise jaws and draw the shape of your punch or die on the other side. Make sure that, when mounted to the vise, the center points of the punch and die line up. In order to quickly exchange tools, I went with magnets to fix them to the vise. First, I used 10x2mm disc magnets, which are way too weak, and then switch to 15x10mm disc magnets. These fix the tools fairly nicely, however you have to be extra carefully not to get anything magnetic next to them. Therefore, I would recommend to just go with multiple smaller ones. Create some pockets in your 3D model and use glue to fix the magnets after printing. Depending on the cleanliness of your shop and the material you are working with, you might want to fully enclose the magnets or at least put some tape on them so they don't collect all the steel chips that might be present. So far, I've been doing what's called air bending. This means the part contacts the press on three points. The bending angle is controlled by how far you push the punch into the part, and the distance of the two other points controls the radius of the bend. A bigger opening will give you a bigger radius, however I haven't found an easy formula to apply here. The other two bending techniques for press brakes are bottom bending and coining. I won't go into detail about those, as they are a bit more complicated, need more force to create a bend, and the tools cannot be used as versatile as those made for air bending. In most cases, you want to use such a V-punch, as it offers the most stability. If you need more clearance, you can switch to a gooseneck punch. Here you can see a perfect example of spring back. This punch has exactly 90 degrees, but after releasing the pressure from the part, it springs back a few degrees. So in this case, the punch needs to have a smaller angle, roughly 2-4 degrees less, to create an exact 90 degree bend. Obviously, we could also use a much sharper shape and just control the bending angle by how far we push it into the part. However, this is going to require a bit more attention and trial and error to create a perfect right angle. In order to get an accurate bending radius, we can use a punch with the same shape as our part, like this one with an 11mm radius. Keep in mind that there's actually a lot more to consider when you want to create very accurate bends. However, this would be out of the scope for this video, and I wouldn't be the right person to explain that to you. But as I said in the beginning, for a home shop guy, this should be good enough for most use cases. The project that got me started with all of this was actually the need for some custom handle strips for a drawer cabinet. This is 1mm steel, and I need to add two 440mm long bends, which means that there will be a lot of back and forth involved. Even though the part is more than 3 times as long as the tools, the bends still look nice and uniform. You can see some marks from the area where the part contacted the die, however these could be polished away fairly easily. This is also an advantage to cheaply made steel tools, which often create much more noticeable marks. Don't worry, I'm going to install some nice front panels later, but now I want to play with my new toy. Hold on, let me try something I've seen online.